Some friendly reminders. Life preservers are located in a pocket in the interior wall of this vessel, at the end of each row of seats. No eating, drinking, or smoking is allowed on the boat or at the memorial. Also, the United States Navy requests, for your safety, that there be no standing while the boat is underway. As we slide away from Halava Stream, we'll be entering the main channel of Pearl Harbor. Off to the right side of the boat is the submarine USS Bofin, an honored and decorated veteran of the Pacific War. The Bofin was launched on December 7, 1942, and was known as the Pearl Harbor Avenger. This vessel is open to the public. In 1941, on a typical Sunday morning in Hawaii, the sun was bright and warm. Clouds hung above the Ko'ola mountain range, now visible off the right side of the boat. At 6 a.m., just north of these mountains, the Japanese Naval Task Force was just 230 miles away. In 15 minutes, the first wave of 183 Japanese airplanes had departed from six aircraft carriers. At 7:05 a.m., the second wave of 167 aircraft joined the attack. A total of 350 planes were headed toward Pearl Harbor. Meanwhile, the American Pacific Fleet was at rest. Over 150 vessels were assembled. That morning, the ships were preparing for church services and shore leave. Along Battleship Row, seven gray warships representing the states of Nevada, Arizona, West Virginia, Tennessee, Oklahoma, Maryland, and California stood majestically along the shoreline of Ford Island. The battleships were tied to the mooring keys. Just ahead, we'll be passing the shore where these ships were docked. You can see their names painted in black letters on the side of the keys. As the sailors in the color detail prepared to raise the American flag at the stern of the battleship Arizona, Lieutenant Commander Sangafuku ran to the quarterdeck, alarmed by the ship's blaring air raid siren.
At that moment, the plane flew very low over the ship with its machine guns. I saw a red ball insignia under the wind and realized it was Japanese.
For the ordinary sailor aboard the ship, it was supposed to be a day of light duty and rest. Seaman Don Stratton had been up early that morning.
For sailors on the bow, something going on there. And we went out and took a look, and I seen the bombs exploding on Fort Island, and we understood exactly who we were right away. We seen the Japanese landing sign. But I just started to meet them from the battle station.
Thank you. Are the other three Japanese as well?
Hard to say from here. I'm guessing probably.
Thank you. crossed over 1,177. And right after the fireball, I looked and I remembered two of my friends that I went to high school with, Jones and Tammy. And I was thinking to myself, God, I hope they're all right. And come to find out later that they were killed in that explosion and they're still on the USS Arizona.
But there were survivors as well. Seaman Donald Stratton was on duty aboard the Arizona that day. He was one of the few men who survived from the area of the deadly explosion.
I didn't know what it was at that time, but it just shook the ship like it was a piece of paper.
The bomb hit on the starboard or right side of the ship and into the magazines. Seaman Donald Stratton was inside the gun director, a steel cube-like structure above the navigation bridge. It was now enveloped in flame.
Attention Navy staff, Lee, please call the front.